year here, all right? Take a look back and assess what's it been like to be coach of the University of Maryland lacrosse team. We know you love it. Tell us about everything.
Yeah, it's hard to believe how much has kind of happened and how long I've been here. It doesn't seem like it's been that long, but it's been everything I could ask for in so many different ways. Just the relationships, the people, the experiences. Obviously, some of the things we've been able to accomplish, but who we've been able to do it with, and just what this program means to so many people, to be part of that, it's second to none. It's really special. And there's not a day that doesn't go by I don't appreciate the job I have.
Was there a lot of Philly love? I mean, Terp love in Philly on Saturday?
It was unbelievable. I'd be lying if I said I didn't get choked up a little bit. Being there and then kind of just standing back and seeing all those kids and seeing what they've done on the field, but what they're doing in their lives. They've all got successful careers in a variety of different areas. Just to see them together and playing hard and having to come back and win a tough game, I thought was awesome. Seeing the parents, they have a tradition here where they hold up the cards and the Terps. They do that with the Whipsnakes now. So saw a lot of families and girlfriends and things like that. So it took me back, and it was really surreal, but great. And just to see them happy, it was phenomenal.
The Jacklers Law Group's successes have resulted in many distinguished awards, including Best Personal Injury Trial Law Firm USA, Maryland's Personal Injury Attorney of the Year twice, and Super Lawyers designation every single year. We succeed because we're willing to try cases, and insurance companies know it. That's why their claim reps often grumble they pay us more in settlements than any other lawyers. You deserve a great lawyer. If you've been hurt in a car, truck, or train crash, call 855-BIG-DOG-1.
That game and kind of what transpired there, and then how long do you let your team reflect on that before you guys move forward?
It's being a spring sport, typically what happens is, if you go to the playoffs, school's over. So as soon as that game happens, usually it's somewhere else, you'll come back here, and then the kids have to get on with their jobs, if they're taking summer school, whatever it may be. So we have a day or two to just kind of do like a inventory, talk to the guys, all right, here's what you need to know for summer, whatever it may be. We try to meet with each guy individually. So we usually are on the clock at that point, about 48 hours, and they're gone. So you do that, and then it's on the recruiting. So you kind of, your attention gets shifted. Certainly you have all summer to kind of think about how the season ended, but then you reflect and go, all right, what are the things that we could do better? What are the things that maybe we could keep building on? And that's really what you're doing. You're really kind of like you've got one eye on the recruiting. You're trying to go out and see the guys that either committed to you or the guys that you're interested in trying to get down for visits. And then you're also like just trying to think about, okay, we didn't go where we wanted to go. What could move the needle for us? Then you're thinking, all right, who's going to be our leaders? How do we help those guys get ready for those types of things? Who's coming in? So there really isn't much time to kind of feel sorry for yourself. Obviously one team is very excited about what the way the season ended, and everybody else wished it would have gone a little bit further.
Coach, what are you working on in fall? What are you looking at for?
We kind of do the same thing every year. We go back to, at the beginning, we assume nothing. Right, we start from zero. So we really go back to fundamentals, the basics. We there's a lot of individual and then team instruction. But on top of that, we've got to go back to building our culture, establishing the leadership. We don't assume anything carries over. So we go right back to these are the things that we're about. We emphasize them, we drill them, and it starts all over again. I love this time of year. The late August hits, the energy on campus, just the excitement. Certainly you're missing some guys, and it's not just because they're talented guys, but you just miss some of the personalities and the relationships that you had. But you're super excited. You see these young faces, the families, even if they're not lacrosse players, just this campus has a certain energy that, at least for me selfishly, helps me every year just get really ramped up and enthusiastic for a new journey. And it, again, makes me really excited and fortunate, feel fortunate for what I get to do.
How do you build the culture back up with your hall of transfers? This is a little bit different makeup of this team, isn't it?
We've had some guys, you know, historically come and go. I think we've seen the, you know, right now we've seen the importance or just the relevance of the transfer portal. You know, kids are coming and going in every sport a little bit easier than ever. We've had some guys leave. We've had some guys come in. I think part of it is you're going to go through some sort of vetting process anytime you're recruiting somebody, whether it's for a job or for a guy that's a, we hope, is a freshman here, same thing as a transfer. You know, what type of guy are they? What type of student are they? The one nice thing about transfer is that you, a lot of times you have film on them. So you can see them, and you know your kids know them, or you know people know them. So there's a good sense that, you know what, they may be a very good fit for your culture. They might have been just somewhere else. Or maybe they've been somewhere else and they realize, you know what, that's something I want to be part of. So, you know, sometimes you'll have guys in your organization that are like, you know what, this maybe isn't what I want. So as much as you try to explain through the recruiting process, this is who we are and this is what we're about, it's until you really get in that spot and you're a young person, you don't know whether it's going to be something you're really excited about or it's something you want to really do for 4 years.
Does it bother you that transfers are becoming such a part of the game? Look, you've lost a lot of great guys and you picked up a lot of great guys. Even we picked up a number one in Chancha. But does it bother you that that's affecting the game so much?
I think we all like a bit more normalcy. You know, you go somewhere, you finish. But I do think it's a bit of a byproduct of early recruiting. You know, we got caught up, and I think all of us, coaches, parents, you know, everybody, families, you know, there are only, you know, 70 some odd lacrosse programs, Division I. There's only so many spots. You know, we were able to recruit younger. A lot of sports do it. I think we got involved in that. And there were a lot of young guys that made decisions that maybe at a time where they weren't ready to make the decisions. And we made decisions when the young guys were still trying to figure out who they are and what they wanted. So I think we saw the impact of that. So backing things off, I think we have the right idea by backing it off. I'm hopeful that it leads to fewer transfers. But I do think if you look at what we see more and more guys moving from one club team to another, moving from one high school to another. So to me, it's logical that you would see more transferring. And you're seeing that in college football. I mean, you see a lot of guys move from one place to another, and sometimes it's situational. You know, you've seen it in some of these quarterbacks. Only one quarterback plays, and you may go and battle it in preseason camp. If you don't win that battle and you're not where you want, there's other programs that you might be able to start for, and that might be a big priority. So maybe you took a swing at it, it didn't work out, and you're just going to go somewhere else. I think at the end of the day, I think all of us are educators. If someone would be happier somewhere else, like, I would never want somebody that is here that didn't really feel like they wanted to be here, or they weren't all in, they weren't that as passionate as they could be. And things change. Guys change their mind. What's important changes. Sometimes guys get hurt. Some things happen with their family. They want to be closer to home. Those are things that I think sometimes people don't realize.
And so, Coach, in regard to the PLL and having the sort of pipeline team at the Whitsnakes, what do you think it does for the professional aspirations of the guys that you have right now that might want to go and find themselves at Whitsnakes in the future?
Yeah, I think, you know, I think the guys realize that is the icing on the cake. You know, we're always trying to get our guys great job opportunities and make sure that our guys, you know, are getting their education first and foremost. But that is a kind of icing on the cake. Wow, wouldn't it be awesome to play with my teammates again? That's what we're seeing a lot of, is like the guys that I talk to, like the Bryce Youngs and Kyle Bernlors, are like, it's so awesome. Every weekend I get to see my best friends. It takes me back in time. And some of them were able to play with maybe the Drew Snyders of the world or Brett Schmidt that were just before them, and now they connect, they play, and again, now they create that bond. So I think it's pretty awesome. The fact that they're all together it was, it, to me, it was an incredible weekend. On Friday night, I got to go to the Bayhawks game and saw seven players there. And then the next day, we had a red-white scrimmage, and then I drove up to Philly and saw like 16 more guys. So I was able to connect with all those guys in a matter of 24 hours. And again, proud of them, not just because they're playing professionally, just it's awesome to see your former players. And you just, you get selfish, you know, you're here, you get to see them all the time, and you don't get to see them as much. So you want to see them and just check in and make sure they're doing okay. But you are kind of like, you know, that proud dad, you know, when you see them out there, just you're glad that they're happy and they're representing the university and the program so well and just doing things the right way.